I tell you, it has been a week just filled with sorrow. The bombings there in Boston, of course, that explosion we told you about in West. And tomorrow, we remember the victims of the Oklahoma City bombing.
And many folks are just asking, how much more of this can we take? KOCO 5's news reporter Ariel Reshef joins us later live in the studio. And Ariel, what's the latest?
Well, Paul and Jess, as you can imagine, many of us were watching the coverage of the horrific explosion in West Texas in disbelief. Just as the country began to heal from the wounds of the Boston bombings, another tragedy.
Flags at half staff, hearts heavy. The images of terror, the sounds of panic, a nation in mourning.
A lot is happening that has traumatized many people. Innocent victims. When these things happen, we feel that the world is not safe anymore. We feel all alienated, alone. One of the most important things for a society, for a community, for friends, and for helpers to do is to really reach out for those people that are hurting.
Dr. Krishna says the human spirit is capable of overcoming tremendous grief.
The community outpouring comes from the heart. And our Oklahoma experience shows that people heal eventually when they have that kind of support.
And Edmond Police Chief Bob Ricks knows that firsthand. He was the lead FBI investigator of the Oklahoma City bombing.
We used it, I think, in Oklahoma City as almost a rallying cry, that it brought everybody together. It became a focal point. What was meant for harm by others, we're going to use for good. We're going to show to the world that we are a special people, we have a special bond, and that you cannot destroy that bond.
Dr. Krishna says healing is also about perspective.
Know how connected we are, how together we are, how much goodness is there in each humanity.
And Dr. Krishna also has some advice for parents. He says you should always be honest with your kids and answer any of their questions about these kind of events, but do it in a calm way. But he also says make sure to limit their exposure to traumatic images. Live in the studio, Ariel Reshef, KOCO 5 News.
Thank you, Ariel. Dr. Krishna says there are many ways to cope with grief. He suggests controlled breathing exercises, meditation and reflection, also getting involved in the community. All of these things, he says, can help in the healing process.